Georges Cuvier is known by many as the father of modern paleontology. One of his most notable contributions to the world is establishing the concept that species can and do go extinct. He first presented this idea in 1796 at the National Institute in France, in a paper that showed how living elephants were anatomically much different than the fossil bones found in the region. Up until that point, it was assumed that those animals still wandered different parts of the earth and had just somehow evaded detection. Even Thomas Jefferson told Lewis and Clark to keep an eye out for any living mastodons on their journey to map out the western United States. But it's not as though fossils weren't a part of world culture and history before the 18th century. We humans have been using the fossil record to explain away the inexplicable for thousands of years. So today, we're talking about fossil myths. One of the most popular stories linking fossils to fables is that of the griffin and the dinosaur Protoceratops. In the book The First Fossil Hunters, the author Adrian Mayer suggests that early Roman and Greek scholars, some 3,000 years ago, encountered Saka Scythian nomads along the trade route between the Mediterranean and Asia. The Scythians were prospecting for gold in the Gobi Desert, which is also known today for its Protoceratops fossils. The Greek author Aristeus wrote down their stories about griffins, these four-legged creatures with a body of a lion and the wings and beak of a bird. Mayer concluded that the Scythian gold miners found these fossils and interpreted them as mythical beasts responsible for guarding the desert's gold, since over time, their fossil nests could collect small bits of gold that would blow across the desert. As popular as this story is, some paleontologists have questioned the interpretation, noting that griffin folklore had existed almost 2,000 years before the Greeks and Romans wrote it down. Plus, it isn't too outlandish to assume that people could come up with the idea of a griffin on their own based off of observations in the natural world. Eagles and lions have always been powerful symbols, so why not just mash them into one? But another mythical creature with potential ties to the fossil record is the Cyclopes. These ancient one-eyed giants were popularized in epic Greek poems by Homer and Hesiod. In 1914, the Australian paleontologist Othniel Abel conjectured that ancient sailors came across fossil dwarf elephant skeletons in coastal caves around Italy and Greece. And being unfamiliar with the concept of elephants, they assumed the gaping hole in the middle of the skull was the single eye socket of an ancient monster. More recently, skeletons of the ancient elephant relative Dinotherium gigantum, which means huge, terrible beast, were found on the island of Crete. These enormous animals stood 15 feet or 4.6 meters high at the shoulder. It's possible other fossil evidence of Dinotherium was discovered by inhabitants around the island, which could have contributed to the Cyclops myth too. The Greeks and Romans weren't the only societies to use fossil evidence as a way of explaining the world around them. Hildoceras bifrons is an extinct species of ammonite that lived 175 million years ago in the early Jurassic, and it's named after the Christian saint Hilda of Whitby. Whitby is located on the shore of North Yorkshire, and its coast contains a rich fossil deposit home to a number of invertebrates, including ammonites. But at the time, it was unclear to residents what they were, and many assumed that they were serpents turned into stone. The story goes that Hilda was tasked with building the new abbey in Whitby, but the coast was plagued with snakes, which were seen as evil omens, and she needed to remove them. To get rid of the snakes, she prayed them into stone and tossed them off of the cliffs where they were found on the shores below. Some savvy fossil dealers would even go so far as to carving snake heads into the ammonites that they found to corroborate the story, and a few can be found in museum collections today. Not all fossil finds were given a zoological interpretation. Thunderstone is a name given to a multitude of different artifacts and fossils, including found stone and flint axe heads. But in parts of Europe up until the early 20th century, belemnites, which are a type of fossil invertebrate, were also called thunderstones. Belemnites were squid-like creatures that had an internal bullet-shaped skeleton, and these fossils are commonly found even today. Thunderstones were worshipped and feared. They were regarded as the powerful physical manifestations of thunder and lightning. The thought was that lightning was produced by a stone shooting from the sky that penetrated deep into the ground, and over time the stone would make its way to the surface, which made sense that they'd be found after heavy rainstorms. Depending on the region, some people hung the thunderstones in the stable to keep their horses from having nightmares, or they kept them in the home to keep the children safe from witches, or they even placed them on a shelf next to the dairy to keep the milk from spoiling. But in general, thunderstones were thought to protect the house from thunder, since it was believed that the thunderstones contained superhuman
powers.
Fossil echinoderms, like sea urchins, sea stars, and sand dollars, have also inspired many mystical tales about witchcraft and supernatural powers. In England, these urchins were called fairy loaves, and they were kept next to the hearth. It was thought that they helped ensure that there would always be bread in the house, and they would offer protection against witches. Other species of fossil sea urchins were believed to be the eggs of snakes, and if one was lucky enough, they could steal the egg, but they'd have to keep it on a cloth and run away across a river to ensure that the egg would retain its magical properties, protecting the thief against deadly poisons. We know more today about our world and its history than has ever been known before. Our interpretation of fossil evidence changes and evolves along with our understanding of past periods and epochs, influenced by a steady accumulation of knowledge based off of physical evidence. And so long as we keep pursuing that curiosity, who knows what our world will look like to us generations from now.
It still has brains on it.